Hello, welcome on my channel. Today I'm gonna start work on something to do with model trains. I'm gonna build this LGB lens decoder, part number 55020. I'm gonna build it in one of my Steins locomotives. It's an older version, which has a split-in-half gearbox. So, and it's not DCC ready. I'm gonna start on it today, and it may be in one video, maybe in two, I don't know. Okay, let's start. The driver broke out when I got it, and we're gonna put him aside. Well, how to open this locomotive? It's been a while since I've done it, so let's go and try. First, you'll notice this water filling pipe. It's from the boiler to the subframe, and it is loose. You can take it out. It might be glued, but this glue is so old it just came out. Put it aside for later. I'm gonna check if there are anything more connected from top to bottom. The steam pipes are also in there, but they're yeah, you can get them out. This is the precious no, this is the exhaust steam pipe. Both sides, they just came off. The ingoing pressure steam. Yeah, don't come out. Well, let it sit there. First, we're gonna do unscrew the funnel, and it's holding place. Holding in place. Everything from the top till the bottom, and there's a nut here. This nut is held in this six-shaped form in this piece of plastic, so you can just unscrew the top slowly, and it should come out. This is a normal funnel, which has no smoke generator in there, so it's not fancy. The nut in the bottom you take out, put it on the funnel so you don't lose it. As you see, I've got a magnet here. That one has to come off. It's not glued. It was a standard LGB version, don't know the number yet. When you unscrew the funnel, the lantern comes loose. You can take the lantern off and put it aside, so that you only hold the bulb. You can even take the light bulb out, put it in the lantern so you don't lose it, and put it aside. Also, which comes loose, is the main front coupling device, and it should be able, you should be able to pull it out like so. Now the front end of the locomotive is loose. To get the rest off the top, at the back there of the cabin there are two screws. You can undo them, so put them aside. We're not there yet. I just saw there are two more. They're here, positioned in the drive. Yes, you can see them there. They don't need to come off. The driver cap should come off now. Is there something else? Yeah, maybe. Well, to find out if there's nothing else, we're gonna take out the coupling, and the couplers can be taken out by undoing two screws here and here. Yep, there you see that there is a plate with the coupler on there. You can leave the screws in there so you don't lose them. Put it aside. Still no room. No, there are no screws furthermore under there. There's only ballast weight. So I think we're just gonna have to undo these two. As I just said, it's been a long while since I took one of these apart. I did it once before, as you can see. Here, it looked like so. Here, you see this is a capacitor. I had the lighting flicker free. At least that was the idea. It worked. There's a little rectifier unit in there. Which so the screws are in the hole. I just pop them out and they fall to the ground. Put it together on the side. So now let's see if we can get this thing apart. Still haven't got it apart. Something is, I took out the rail cleaner here in front, took out the screw there, and I'm still not able to take it apart. I don't get it. It should come off now. Something should come off. We're getting somewhere. Yeah. Okay. This is your whole gearbox. And as you can see, there is nothing there to connect power to. Nothing? Well, these two connectors, this one here, this one and this one, these two are connected to the wheels, the power pickup in the wheels, the sliders, and they're also connected to the motor. That is why this engine, this is just simple, and it connects to the lights in the locomotive via, and I know you can see it, yes, these two screws there. This screw holds, is the third screw that holds the cap in place. Then we're gonna take it out. It's a longer one. Put it apart aside. Now we should be able to get the loco apart. There we go. Ballast weight's coming out. Piece of plastic comes out. My electronics comes out, which I have put in long time ago. Really long time ago. up to the decoder anyway. Take it out so that I can take the nice. Took it out. In this hole, we're gonna put. Here we'll go. Our decoder board. So we've got the train apart. Cut the wires loose. As I said, I'm gonna leave this big capacitor under there. Well, we're gonna need to get the power from the wheels and the track up to our. When you wanna put it together, you need to snap these back in place. Well, of course, this one. Yep, gone. There it went. So, power to the train comes from here, these two protrusions there, here and here. And yeah, they sit on the opposite side of the block engine, the gearbox, on these two lips here. Those two. This one connects to this side of the train and this to that one. But forget the old noise, those things. So, and those are these two screws in there. We're not gonna use that anymore. No, we're not. What we now need to do is take the gearbox apart. Why? Well, we have four wires coming from our decoder. Two of these wires will go to the track, and I think it's these two outsides. And because I took the liberty of taking off the original wires and putting on my own, so I have a little bit of a mismatch in colors, but that's not a problem. I will Google the instructions for this on the internet. Two of these wires need to connect to the rail contacts, to the tracks via the wheels and the power takeoff. The other two need to go to the engine. But as you can see, there are no connections for that. You have four, this one, two, three, and four, but this one is connected to there, and that one is connected to there. So, how are we going to get this in? Well, it should be simple, and it is. First, we're gonna need to take off the drive system, and I see it is broken. I glued it on sometime at one point, so I used my trains on exhibitions, and where did he go? There he is. Take this off carefully, not to break it. Already did. Oh yeah, really destroyed it. Didn't know that was broken. And as you pull slightly, you see the cylinders come off. And you can take most of the stuff apart. Normally, this is glued, is in place like this. And it is intact, only on my train it's broken off. Well, it's making work a little bit easier for me. So, I'm gonna take off the rear. There's no track cleaner. there's this ballast, I don't know. This is an extra ballast weight, don't know if I can take it off. Don't know how it works. Well, okay. Now, we need to split this engine apart. And we need to take off the wheels. Ooh. What I'm going to do now, it isn't pretty, but I'm doing it. Like so. Now we have the gearbox almost ready. Take off the wheel. Oh well. Be sure to keep the front wheels and back wheels together. It's a pretty it is a machine screw. It's, I don't know if it will focus on there. No, it will not. But it has a fine thread, and there's a little, there's this ring in there. I don't know if it will come out. Yeah, it will. It dropped. There. It's a rattling screw to keep the wheels on without rattling. Find a take off the other one. It also has a ring. Now you can take the wheels off. Haha. It sits in here and there's a spring. So mind you, taking off because they can jump out. I let it come to my finger so I didn't lose it. But this is how it looks like. And there's a small side on the spring, and there's a bigger side on the spring. The bigger side goes into the tube first, and the small side sits under the brush. That's the word I was looking for. Brush. So that's it is. Take off the other wheel again. Watch out that you don't lose the brush. Can see they're a little bit worn, but they're okay. These are fairly, this is almost their original length. I have it on my thumbnail. Don't have the biggest hands, but okay. Now we have these four screws here. I'm gonna undo them. So now, as you can see, we can slowly open up the gearbox. It should come apart. Yep, there we have it. Look at the massive motor in there. What you should mind now is that you mark or notice the black side of the motor is facing you. This is the front end of the locomotive, like so. It's the front end, and this is the rear end. the black side of the motor is on your left, and the red side of the motor is on the right. This is always the case with the Bueller motors. Why? Well, if you turn them in like this, and I forgot something, ha ha ha, I'm an idiot. With these old motor houses, maybe you can see it, I will show you. Look there. This is where the gear, the motor, sits, the axle of the motor sits in. And as you can see, there's a little ball bearing there. I just lost one. No, found it. Look, a little ball bearing. It sits in there. There. You need to watch it. It needs to stay there. Don't lose it. Why not? Well, otherwise your engine, your axle of the engine, moves too much. You can see, as I turn the gears, the axle moves. It's a little bit annoying because my camera doesn't react. I do it up and it's a little slow, but okay, that's something. But this is what happens, and that's why you need to keep those two ball bearings in place. Oops, it comes out again because of the magnetism of the motor gear. Yeah, there's the other one. Take them out. Put them apart away. How are you saying are we going to get power from this to this motor? Where does this motor get its power from? Well, as you can see, these taps here, and this gearbox is omnidirectional. You can turn it at either way because it's always the same. These taps here are where the engine, and especially on this locomotive here, this one, this is where the engine makes contact on this pole here. And in the other side, there you can see, is the other lip. It is this stuff which does that. This is the metal, the conductor here. And this also contacts with the power pickups, which are also there, and they all connect up. Now what we're gonna have to do is take the part out, these parts out, because we don't want the motor making direct contact, like so, to these contacts. We don't want that. We want the motor to make contact. We want to get wires on here which go to the decoder. Now let's do something I don't think a lot of people like, but it's the safest way. We're gonna bend it up. As you can see, I've bent it up. Bend it down, up, down, up, down a few times until it snaps. There's your pickup. Now that's gone. And now we're gonna do the other side. As you can see, if you you don't need to take this one out, you only need to take this one out. It's at the rear. Why it's at the rear? Well, and how can you tell? There's a slot here, there, and it's not present there. It's nice and black, so so we're gonna need to take that one out as well. Do it the same as the other one. Prik, prik. And it snaps off. Are we done yet?
No.
We need to solder wires to the motor contacts. And we need to get those wires out of the block, out of the gearbox, and into the locomotive. How are we going to do that? We need to drill a hole. I'm gonna do that today. Let's get the stuff aside and I'm gonna solder on the wires to the motor. I'm gonna tin the ends of the contacts of the engine. Just apply a little bit of solder, let it flow. Nice and smelly. So just tin it. Do the same on the other side. Just put a little bit of tin on there because these connections of this engine, this motor has a great thermal capacity, so it takes a while for them to heat up. But putting a little bit of tin on your tip and holding it against it will get a better contact. And we need to strip the wires. And there are, I use my side cutters as you can see, but there are of course specialist wire strippers and stuff like that to strip the ends. I'm gonna tin the wire. So just tin it, you probably can't see it, but you need to tin it up, put a little bit of solder on there, because that will make a nice, better contact. So they are a little bit too long, but we're gonna cut them off. Later. First we're gonna put the wires on the engine, on the motor, and well, we need to see how it will fit in there. So I'm gonna put the motor in there, in the gearbox, and just see how the wire should come out. And I think pointing up like that, in the same route as the copper, the brass connector did. So we're gonna do that, but now you can put it on like so, or you can do it like this and then bend it over, and I'm gonna do the last. It's a little bit too long, so we're gonna cut off a little the end off. And now, actually, we need more hands than this. As you can see, the wires are running away like this. And now we're gonna need to drill some holes. I'm gonna drill some holes in the gearbox. Now, if you're looking really good, you can see where the strip is running. It's going around here. Now, roughly here, is where the old connection was. So you should think, okay, drill it there, but you can better drill it here, roughly here. Then you can take the wires out and they will go in and come out here instead of coming out under this piece. So better to drill there, make it yourself, make yourself easy, then drill the hole there. And we're through. Now the other side. To be roughly. Is this going to work? No. Check the location of your hole. Maybe you're a little bit off. Yes, I am a little bit off. Use a drill that will fit the wire, or the wire will fit through that hole. Don't know, no matter what size it is, if it will fit, then it's okay. So, that's that. Well, we're gonna put the motor back in, and as we're gonna put it back in the way we took it out. The wire through the hole. You can bend the wire a little bit when it's a little bit bendy like this. You can bend the wire to go into the hole. So you bend it a little bit like a hook, and then you can fumble it into the hole and it will pop out. So now we're gonna fit the ball bearings back in their holes there and there, like so. Take the wire, pull it while you're taking the motor in, and stick it in place. On the rear of the motor, I should have mentioned it, there's a little notch. There's my screwdriver. That's my phone here. There's a little notch here, and that will fall into the gearbox housing, so that the motor cannot rotate. And of course on the other side the ball bearing has fallen out again. Go. It's on there. Gonna leave it out for a little bit longer. There it is again. Fell out. Because we're gonna need to check the wheels. The other one fell out as well. Gonna need to check the wheels. Why? Well, as you can see, they're offset. So if this one is here, that one should be there as well. So I'm gonna rotate it while the engine is loose. Then stick it in. It should be like this. If you've done that, then you can turn it back around to stick this piece back in. Otherwise we'll forget it and we don't get it in. Now we're gonna put the ball bearings back in, like so, like so, and these two should line up. They don't, then you will have a problem. Then you can put the other side of the gearbox over it. Get it on. Might be a little bit fiddly because you need to get all these things in. Line everything up. Pull on the wire. So that's back in. Check that the wire is free. Running, so put the screws back in. Now, when you put screws in plastic, as you can see now, I'm turning them counterclockwise. Why am I doing this? Well, it's very important. You should hear a click. When you hear that, stop turning and turn it, screw it in place. Why do I do this? So as not to damage the threads which are already in the plastic. If you were to just screw them in place, you will ruin the threads inside. And if you do it too often, you will ruin them and you won't be able to tighten them up again. And that's a shame, because it's not necessary. Also, don't use power tools on this, because it's very easy to overtake them. Snap and turn them in. You should be able to do it with two fingers on there. If it doesn't go in like with two fingers, then something is wrong. And I will need to make haste. Okay, gearbox is back together again, and check the wheels. Before you put the other one on, it runs smoothly, no jitters. Okay, fine. We're gonna put the wheels on, but you have to check that you have the right wheel. The one with the long stud goes to the back, the long with the short stud goes to the front. First, we're gonna put in the brush. Put it in, bluff, there it went, got it back, put it in, put your finger on it, put the wheel next to it, and put it over like so, and turn the wheel until it snaps on. Check that the brush is okay. It is, and now you can put the spring washer, that's the name, spring washer, and the lug nut bolt back on there. Wrong one. Need to have this one. It's a little bit difficult for me because I have the camera in front between me and the gearbox, so it's not it's a little bit difficult. Tighten it, and I should use a better screwdriver. Found one. Whoa, a lot of drivers. A few moments ago I've thought about it, and found it again. So, it's back in. Don't over tighten it, as I just did. Will hold. Put in the next one. Oh, next one. Same deal as with the other wheel. Now you have to put it in the same orientation as this one. Put it on like so that you can hold the brush in with the wheel. And snap it back on. Clip. There it went. Last. As you can just see, one broke off. Okay, gonna do the other one first. I'm gonna repair this. It's also one thing, don't use a too big a screwdriver. You might over tighten a bit and then you snap something off. Luckily, I have another locomotive. However, before I gonna do that, take the wheel back off. And I need to see if I can fiddle this bit out. There you see, that's when you use too much force. I'm gonna get the donor locomotive. Get it off, yeah. Thing inside, so put that back. Gonna put the wheel back on, and now we will try not to snap. Same orientation. If you can see it, the spring washer is already in place. So, don't over tighten, just use your fingers. On. That's it. So we have the two wires now here coming from the gearbox, but we still need two more wires. Now I haven't got different colors as this, so I'm gonna use the same wires. Strip the wires, we're gonna tin them. Always tin your wires. It's better, it's nicer, looks, as you can see the temperature is up and we can do the soldering. I need to clean my tip. You can do that with a piece of cloth, just like this, and it's nice and clean again. Don't do it with tablecloth. I'm actually using an old bathing hand towel. I'm gonna tin now the both of the connections in here. Going to tin now both connections in here. Going to zoom in a little bit on that. Get it to work, don't know. Gonna tin it. Put a little bit of tin on the pad there so that you get a nice heat conductivity on there. And just tin it like that. It will smoke a little bit, but that's okay. Do the other one. Now to don't make mistakes in keep the colors together. So if this is the engine wire, which is red, it comes from the engine, then the red one, and it's on the right hand side of the locomotive. Put the other red wire also on the right hand side of the locomotive. That is nice. Logical. Make sure you do a good connection there. Black wire on the other pad. For some reason, give it a little bit of pull, and you know it's secure. It isn't the best soldering I did, but. It's on there. Shield? No. It's on there. Zoom out a little bit. So that's the drive gear, the gearbox.